Ja, mein Name ist Rainer Schmidt, I'm for Harting. Harting is a player in industrial automation and especially in connectivity and cabling there. And my subject for today is single piece in it. We heard from some other companies already today. I want to give you a small short overview about this technology and what will happen in the next future. Starting with this picture, we call this single piece Ethernet ecosystem. Ecosystem describes more or less everything what is needed to implement such a new technology over the time. So that covers not just the products, not just cables, connectors, but also PHYs, chipsets, switches for the next time, and for instance also standards. Standards are very important to implement such a technology. Test standards, test equipment, and it's going into the devices and then also up to the application, up to the field where single-pane Ethernet technology is used then. If you start with the technology, you can see that we have a lot of different layer today, so that means we have cable and wireless solution, and for the cable-based solution we have copper and fiber cables, and for copper cables very often we are using four-pair cables. That is what state-of-the-art for structured cabling system today. And we get now a new cable-based system, and that is single-pair Ethernet. That is just using one pair of, let's say, today four-pair cables to make the solution smarter and to address new applications. If you are looking where it comes from, the whole history of single-pair Ethernet is very much connected to the automotive industry. So the car manufacturers started initiatives to develop single-pair Ethernet to replace bus systems and other analog services within the cars. So a lot of new features are coming up in the cars, security features and also entertainment systems implemented in the cars, and also some future technologies like autonomous driving and these things. And for this reason, car manufacturers are looking for a technology as an suitable as infrastructure, as a new infrastructure for the cars. And so they started a lot of developments, and first they get also some solutions, and that's going on today also in other applications. So, what's one here? And from the technology base, it is more or less simple. If you can see, we started with fast Ethernet, with 100 megabit volts in the past, with two pairs or with a quad construction in the design, and going then with gigabit Ethernet to a four-pair construction in the copper cable, and the four-pair construction for gigabit Ethernet is a full duplex transmission path in four pairs, and the single pair is just using one of these four pairs, more or less, with the same basic technology. Technology. So, and for the applications outside of the car, the industry, especially the industrial automation, is very important, because of we have in all the industrial automation more or less structures like in an IT network, except in the sensor actuator network. That is these red colors at the end on the bottom, where we have in the field level, other sensors, actuators working there, we have proprietaries, we have bus systems, or we have special analog services driving these sensors and actuator network. And to combine it with the, okay, if you want to combine the infrastructure already exists from, let's say, from the cloud or from the standard IT network in the company up to the sensor actuator network, you need the same basic technology. And that's Ethernet today. And for this reason, CAP Ethernet is so much important, especially also for the industry. So standardization important, second part of our ecosystem. So here you can see a little bit about the international standardization within ISO IEC. In the center you see these ISO IEC SC25. There's a working group 3 for cabling. At the end of the day, there are these standard documents 11801 is coming from. The whole document series for structured cabling is made in this working group. And this working group covers a lot of experts all over the world. And important is that we also define transmission channels. And we fix also, we define limit lines for these transmission channels. At the end of the day, you get transmission classes, class D or class E, you already know. And behind that, you will find the categories for the components, for the cables and connectors, Cat6, Cat6A, Cat7, and so on. All the stuff is coming from these working group 3. And we are also working on the standards for single-pair Ethernet. And you see a lot of other standard bodies and organizations around. And so we have a very good connection and cooperation also, for instance, with IEEE, what is doing the protocols, the Ethernet protocols, also for single-pair. And we have also a relationship to a lot of other people, for instance, to the Senelec for the European standards, that is the EN series, 5173 and other ones. And we are going to the component standards, for instance, for cables and connectors. Why it is important? That you have a consistency in all the documents. That means that you will find the same limit lines and the same definitions and the same major parameters in all of the documents. And that is the case for single-pair Ethernet. So throughout the documents, from the ISO IEC through TIA up to the component standards, you will find a complete described and defined system for single-pair Ethernet cabling. So that is then one of the component standards coming out that is really right now in preparation for publishing, will be published end of the year, and that described a connector standard, that is an industrial connector for single-pair Ethernet using just one pair, so it's a very small one. You can see it here in the outside area. Dimitrios has some samples there on the booth. And so that is already available. There are different types, but the core interface is all the time it's the same. So that is a basic for all this cabling stuff. That is the IEEE Ethernet, and especially single-pair Ethernet protocols defined. And you can a little bit see on the X side that you see the length or the reach. And we are going now with single-pair Ethernet up to 1,000 meters. That might be also an advantage for a lot of applications, that we are not any longer limited to 100 meter. But the price to do it is the bandwidth. So we are going just with 10 megabit over the 1,000 meters. And if you're going to the top, then you can see that we have, for instance, multi-gig application for 2.5 and 5 gig, what also the Cisco already referred to. And you have, for instance, 1 gigabit with a region just of 40 meter today. So all this is in development, and we expect that we will have also a 100 meter channel for the next time. But for the moment, there are 2 important channels for single pair Ethernet. One is for the 1 gigabit and 40 meters, and one is for the 10 megabit and the 1,000 meters. So, and if you are looking a little bit into the future, that is what we are doing also from the standardization standpoint, what we have to develop next. So we will, enhance a lot of today cabling standards to other reach, to a better reach. And so you can see here, for instance, also these 1 gig up to 150, 200 meters perhaps. So there's something in movement, there's very, very much in development, but already existing and already defined are the 1 gig for 40 meter and the 10 megabit for the 1,000 meter. So, consistency between the different standard bodies, TIA and ISO EC. You have heard something about connectivity for data centers or for building installation, that is these a special connector based on a C style that was also already here shown in other presentations, and that is the industrial style. And so for the industrial style, the single pair Ethernet connector is not just one connector. You can see from the top it is an IP20 rated connector, and it's going down then really to a very proved and then very robust connector in an M8 and M12 housing, so it's suitable really for the industry and for harsh environments. So that is what the document's saying. So we are already working in ISO IEC for an amendment for the 11801-3, that is industrial cabling, and parallel also for the part 1, that is the generic cabling. And we are working in the TIA to an addendum, this is the addendum B for the 1005 paper, that is also the industrial cabling, covering also all the, or referencing also the cable and connector standards. So a little bit more to the connectivity. Once again, our ecosystem, now we are with the connectivity. That is a typical transmission path, how it is used in the car today, for instance. And you can see that we have there the MAC layer on the left and the right. That is an end-to-end connection at the end of the day with a PHY between and the related chipsets, so that you can realize or that you can make this transmission true. That is already existing. So these kind of channels are already working, chipsets and PHY are available. And my company, Harding, for instance, have already products working with this kind of chipsets for switch and for media converter, so that we are working with some companies at the moment for the first implementation of this technology into new products. So that is a little bit in detail how it works with the different locking mechanism, and you can see in all the cases the core of this connector type is the same. Also even here in the M12 connector, that is the same kappa ferrule, let's say, what you can find also in the IP21, what is a very heavy and very nice connector type. Then we have it in different housings, also this plastic housing, so that is very simple to use and it's very space saving, and it's a really smart product. So that is a little bit the portfolio overall, and what you can see here also, it is the great interest in these single pair Ethernet stuff is not just that you are using one pair instead of 4 pairs. it is also that you can combine it with remote powering. It's called PoDL, power over data line. That means all devices, smaller devices, needs power. You have an excellent solution with a cable and 100% access to all the data all the time, so it's a very secure system for power and signal, for power and Ethernet. And that's how it looks then at the end. So a little bit more to the different types of connectors and why we have it in. So all that you can find in the documentation. That is a special connector with two additional power contacts, what is very common in the industry if you have more than just 2 amps to transmit to the device, then we have such a hybrid connector here. This design is coming from Tyco Electronics. We are cooperating in single-pair Ethernet stuff with Tyco to bundle also the portfolio and to have a better argumentation and a better portfolio for our customers to introduce single-pair Ethernet. So application, that might be also interesting, where the single-pair Ethernet is used in the next time. So that is the argumentation for why we are using single-pair Ethernet in general. So supporting all the mega trends in the industry, what we have to do, cloud computing and in the industry sector, integrated industry, sure, all these things. And the impact to the connectivity and cabling is higher transmission performance, bandwidth, IP rated data services replaces bus systems and other services. Miniaturization is such a point, and nevertheless simple but confident operation. All that are reasons to implement that single-pair Ethernet in the different applications. That is an important slide here. If you are going from the left to the right, you see the three big application fields of applications for single-pair Ethernet. And that is also a little bit from the left to the right. For my understanding, what means the time this technology is implemented in. So first of all, it starts in the car. What I said already, that you have Ethernet onboard systems, that you have all the security system, drive assistance systems, but also the preparation of autonomous drive, entertainment system, and so on, in the car just by Ethernet. So that will come, the next generation of cars will work already with the single-pair Ethernet stuff. The second one is the industry. That is the sector I come from. So all these single-pair Ethernet addresses the sensor actuator networks. So not so much the classical automation switches and also controller, but first of all, sensors and actuators. Sensors and actuators are the major driver for all these integrated industry and also at the end of the day for Internet of Things. And so we will integrate into the industry to the today's solutions and replace it more and more these sensor actuator networks. And we are going sure also in the process automation, that means chemical, energy, gases, all these things, where the 1,000 meters come from, but we are going also into the robotics, or for instance into the traffic and traffic control, really railway application, where this 40 meter channel is very important. And that works very simple, and that will come also very soon. And the third field of application is all what I call it enterprises, or let's say building installation. So the same idea what the industry has to replace old bus systems by Ethernet in the sensor actuator networks, the same idea is behind the enterprise guys or the building installation guys. they think about all the services in building automation. What is very much driven from special services you have today, for instance, this KNX, and you have a Japanese protocol today there, and I think more than 20 other services. So they have also the idea to replace all these special services by an Ethernet-based one to have a common and an easy communication from the IT infrastructure today up to any controller or sensors actors in the building. And then so far, you can see the basic idea to use this technology is the same for all of 403. But coming in the car first, then in the industry, and later on in the building automation. So that are some use cases Harding is looking for. So you can see, especially in automation, we are using the benefits of single pane Ethernet in the robotics, also in the transportation, in machineries, and so that are all applications using mostly different, that means other protocols than Ethernet today. So that are the use cases for the future in the industry. Yeah, one picture of the single pane Ethernet stuff at the end. And with this picture, I would close my short presentation here. Hope to give you a little bit of an overview about single pane Ethernet, that the international standards are available today. IEEE is finalized. So the CG standard for 1,000 meter was finalized, I think, 2 weeks ago, something like that. We are in the work with the cabling standards and ISO IEC as well as in TIA, but we guess that we will get finalized some of the amendments in the next 12 months. So I would expect that we will get the standards ready there to the end of next year at latest. And we are going also into the products and into the solution so that this new technology becomes true then. So if there are any questions, I'm quite open for it. I will be here also for a time, so if anybody wants to contact me. Otherwise, you will find my contact details in the documentation prepared here from this beautiful girl behind me. And if there's anything, so give me a call. We are happy to support you. Thank you very much.